Okay, students, now let us discuss what are the conditions of common roots. That means whenever two algebraic equations are given, if the root is common among both the two algebraic equations, what will be the condition for solving those type of equations? Let us see. Now let us consider first one. One common root, that means why one common root? Because for algebraic equations you may get maximum two roots. Clear? For every algebraic equation you have two roots, or they may be equal, they may be different, or anything, it may be anything, but you have two roots for one algebraic equation. Now if I have two algebraic equations of the type a1x plus a1x square plus b1x plus c equal to 0 and a2x square plus b2x plus c 2, this is c1, equal to 0. Of this type you have two algebraic equations. Clear? For this type of two algebraic equations you get total four roots. That means two from first equation, two from second equation. If you solve equation one, you get two roots. If you solve the second equation, you get two roots. So in that case, if the equation one and if equation two are having one root as common in both of the equations, then what will be the condition to solve those type of things? That means if I consider alpha is common for both equations. If alpha is common for both the equations, then what we have to do? If alpha is common for both the equations, what this equation becomes? It will be a1 alpha square plus b1 alpha plus c1 equal to 0. This will be a2 alpha square plus b2 alpha plus c2 equal to 0. So this time you are going to have two equations using the root of common which is having for both. So by using the common root for both the equations, these two will be the terms. Now let us simplify equation 1 and equation 2. By solving equation 1 and equation 2, you will be knowing what is alpha. So that will be what? Alpha square divided by b1 by b2, c1 c2, alpha by c1 c2, a1 a2, 1 divided by a1 a2 b1 b2. So this thing all of you know how to simplify. Clear, students? So by using this method, now I will find what is alpha if the alpha is common for both the equations. Clear, students? If alpha is common for both the equations, you are going to have this type of equation, equation 1 and equation 2. If you want to find alpha, let us use this method that is called as Cramer's rule, or you call it as cross multiplication method of solving this particular equation. Now this will be equal to what? Alpha square divided by b1 c2 minus b2 c1. b1 c2 minus b2 c1. This will be equal to alpha divided by c1 a2 minus a1 c2. This will be equal to 1 divided by a1 b2 minus b1 a2. So this will be the terms. Clear, students? So alpha square divided by b1 c2 minus b2 c1, alpha divided by c1 a2 minus a1 c2, 1 divided by a1 b2 minus b1 a2. So these terms you are going to have. So by using this, now what will be alpha equal to? alpha square equal to, it will be alpha square by alpha equal to b1 c2 minus b2 c1 divided by c1 a2 minus a1 c2. This will be the term. That means alpha equal to, this is nothing but alpha. Clear? One more thing, alpha will be equal to what? C1 a2 minus a1 c2 divided by a1 b2 minus b1 a2. So this will be your alpha and this will be your alpha. Equate these two terms. If you equate these two terms, you are going to have what is alpha equal to. Finally, what is alpha equal to? Alpha equal to, that is b1 c2 minus b2 c1 multiplied with a1 b2 minus b1 a2. So now if you equate this alpha and this alpha, you are going to have b1 c2 minus b2 c1 multiplied with a1 b2 minus b1 a2. That will be equal to c1 a2 minus a1 c2 multiplied with c1 a2 minus a1 c2. So this will be your alpha term. Clear, students? It looks very big, but in problems, whenever you are solving, it will be very simple. See, condition for the common roots will be b1 c2 minus b2 c1 into a1 b2 minus b1 a2 equal to c1 a2 minus a1 c2 into c1 a2 minus a1 c2. So students, how to remember this particular formula? That is very, very important. Clear? You have two equations. Please very cautious while explaining this. You have two equations. I want to write alpha equal to, so I will start with b1. After b, you must go to c2. b1 c2 minus b2 c1. b1 c2 minus b2 c1 multiplied with a1 b2 minus b1 a2. Are you getting my point? Or you can write it as minus a2 b1. Okay, students. Now you got, how you got this term? That is b1 c2 minus b2 c1 into a1 b2 minus b1 a2. So this is 1, this is 2. Clear? That means 1, 2. 1 and 2 are multiplied to each other. Now see here, c1 a2, that means c1 a2. Clear? I will write like this, c1 a2 minus a1 c2, c1 a2 minus a1 c2. This is third one, cross multiplication, the end terms. Otherwise, you can also write it as c1 a2, that means big arrow you have to write. C1 a2 minus a2 c1. Clear? First two, second two, third two. Clear? So that is c1 a2 minus a1 c2. The fourth one will be what? Again same, c1 a2 minus a1 c2. So you got both the same terms, a1 c, yes, c1 a2 minus a1 c2 into c1 a2 minus a1 c2. That is, here you multiplied it with c1 a2 minus a1 c2 into c1 a2 minus a1 c2. that will be nothing but square. Clear students? A1 C2 minus A2 C1 whole square, that will be your square, because you are having two terms, so for that reason you are having it as square. Clear? So from this you must write three terms. First one, A1 B1 C2 minus B2 C1 into A1 B2 minus A2 B1, next that is equal to A1 C2, that is equal to A2 C1 minus A1 C2. Clear? So whenever you are starting with first term B1 C2 B2 C1, here A1 B2 A2 B1, next whenever you are going for the third term, you start with A2 C1 minus A1 C2 whole square, that will be your alpha. I am explaining just because you must know to solve it very quickly. You no need to solve all these terms. Are you getting my point? If no problem, you all this and solve it, you will get the correct answer. If you remember the technique, then also you will get the correct answer. Clear students? Once again, I will explain the clear thing of this particular term, which is equal to this. So you observe very carefully. That is, if you have two equations, A1 x square plus B1 x plus C1 equal to 0, second one is A2 x square plus B2 x plus C2 equal to 0. Now I want to solve common root alpha. See how I will write directly. First thing, B1 C2, I am finding alpha root B1 C2 minus B2 C1 multiplied with A1 B2 minus A2 B1 equal to, now I will start with A2 C1 minus A1 C2 whole square. See, this will be the same thing. If you remember this to write, then it will be very, very simple. First these two, next these two, last the end elements. This with end elements for the third one, start with A2 C1 and minus A1 C2 for the third one. First one left side, second one right side, third one the end side. Clear students? If you change these two terms, no problem, because it is square, your answer will be going to be the same, so no problem. Hence, this is what the technique you have to remember to solve the common root. Now let us solve one of the question which is asked in your IIT exams. I am discussing just this because this type of questions going to be asked in competitive exams. So one example I will solve which was asked on this particular concept. So common root question, based on the common roots, one of the question has been asked in one of the IITs. So for that reason, let us try to solve this. I think you remember the technique to write how to solve whenever there is a common root in between two algebraic equation. Directly I am going to use that technique which I have explained before this problem. So using that technique, I will solve this particular problem directly. That is AX square plus BX plus C equal to 0, BX square plus CX plus A equal to 0. Using these two, I will write my root alpha directly, BA minus C square into AC minus B square equal to BC minus a square whole square. Clear students? I will write these terms directly by using alpha root common, which I have explained already. Clear? So by using that, ba minus c square into ac minus b square. This is first two terms equal to, the third term is bc minus a square. So it will be very simple. You can solve it very fast if you remember that technique. So see now, ba ac, that is a square bc minus b cube a, this is minus c cube a plus b square c square, that is equal to, simplify this, bc whole square plus a raised to 4 minus 2a square bc. These terms you are going to have. Clear? So now by using this, you can simplify the terms. See, bc whole square, here you can cancel bc whole square. Now remaining with what? You take all the terms on LHS, that will be what? A raised to 4 minus 2a square bc. See, here one a square bc, if it comes this side, it will be minus 3a square bc. You take on this side, it will be plus b cube a. You take this on this side, it will be c cube a equal to 0. So now, in all a is common, you take a cube plus b cube plus c cube, you take a common, minus 3abc will be equal to 0. If you take a on that side, it will be equal to 0. Therefore, a cube plus b cube plus c cube divided by abc will be equal to 3. If you simplify this particular term, clear students? So here you have to see that if you know the technique, you can apply it very quickly and you can simplify. That is, a cube plus b cube plus c cube divided by abc is equal to 3. So therefore, your answer will be 3. So this is your answer. See how you can solve if you know the techniques of particular problems whenever you are solving. So for that reason, make students be perfect whenever there is a common root. One common root I am seeing. If there is a one common root, this is what? Your technique to simplify. Clear students? In this, your answer is 3. Now, let us discuss if we have two common roots. That means, whenever you are having two common roots, what you have to do? That is, a1x square b1x plus c equal to 0, a2x square plus b2x plus c2 equal to 0 are having both common root. Both are common root. If both are common root, then a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. On this basis, again there are so many questions to simplify. So my dear students, if both are common, a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. If one is common, we already know that b1 c2 minus b2 c1 multiplied with a1 b2 minus a2 b1 equal to a2 c1 minus a1 c2 whole square. So one common, both are common. These two things you have to be perfect. You try to solve more and more problems on these two things. Clear students?